Gyronix.
In this lecture, we'll be solving systems of linear equations, and this will be our topic outline. First, we will define what is a linear equation, then the system of linear equations, and of course, we are going to solve system of linear equations. And we have two methods for that. We can use either substitution or elimination method. Okay, so first is the linear equation. Linear equation is simply an equation that can be expressed as the sum of products of coefficients and variables. So which means we are going to multiply the coefficient and the variable. Okay, and the sum will be equal to constant. So this is the general form of a linear equation. We have coefficient A and we multiplied to X. So we have a lot of coefficients A from A sub 1 to A sub 2. Okay, those are the coefficients. And of course, X sub 1, X sub 2, and so on are the variables. So this is the format, coefficient times variable. So it is called linear since the power of the variables are raised to 1. So which means this equation, the degree of this equation is 1. So we don't see a variable like x squared, x sub 1 squared, x sub 2 squared, and if you have degree 2, that will make our equation a quadratic equation. So the graph of linear equation is a line, a straight line. Okay? And if you have, let's say, x squared for the quadratic equation, the graph is a parabola. So one thing to, again, to note is that the power of the variables are raised to 1. So there's no x squared, x cubed, and so on. Okay? The specific example of a linear equation is this one. So we have 2x minus 3y plus 4z equals 45. Again, you don't see variable raised to 2 like y squared, or variable raised to 3 like z cubed. All the variables have exponent 1. So this make the equation linear. Okay, x, y, and z are the variables. Of course, 2, negative 3, and 4 are the coefficient, and the constant is 45. Okay, so let's have a little bit of an exercise. Which of the following is a linear equation? So obviously, letter A, so we have x squared, that is the square of a variable, so this is not a linear equation, since the variable is raised, in this case, x squared. Okay, A is not a linear equation. Letter B, so the variables all are raised to 1, but this one is a product of a variable. So we have u times v. It's not a single variable. So a linear equation has the format coefficient times variable only, not two variables. So u times v, okay, this is not a linear equation. Okay, obviously, letter C is a linear equation. So we can transfer this constant positive 2 to the right side. So that will make that negative 2. And this 6b minus square root of 2c, we can transfer to the left side. So if we rearrange those terms, the resulting new equation is 5a minus 6b plus square root of 2c equals negative 2. So the format is coefficient times variable, coefficient times variable, coefficient times variable equals a constant, which is negative 2. So letter C is a linear equation. Okay, next is a system of linear equations. So with S, which means we have a lot of linear equation. So simply, this is a set of linear equations in the same variables. Now when we say the same variables, the value of that variables are equal. So the value of b here is also the value of b here. Okay? This one we don't have b, which is that is equal to 0. So we have three equations, three linear equations. So a set of that is called a system of linear equations. And the solution for this equation is a set of values that satisfies every equation in the system. So for example, the solution for this system of linear equations is a equals to 1, b equals to 2, and c equals to 3. So these values of variables, this a equals to 1, b equals to 2, c equals to 3, will satisfy, okay, every equation of the system. So which means when we are going to like substitute, let's say a is 1 here, b is 2 here, c is 3 here, that will equate to 11. The same with other equations. So we can substitute the value, these values, and that will satisfy every equation. Okay, so let's substitute the values. Okay, first, the first equation. So we'll substitute the value of a, b, and c, which is 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so we have 2 times a, which is 1, 3 times b, which is 2, and plus c, which is 3. So 2 times 1 is 2, 3 times 2 is 6, plus 3. Okay, so this 2, 2 plus 6 is 8, plus 3 is 11. Okay, so that satisfies the first equation. And we can do the same with the second equation. So that is b plus 2c. Okay, b is 2, c is 3. Okay, so this is 6 plus 2 is 8. Okay, so it satisfies the second equation. And the last one is a plus 3 times c. So a is 1. Of course, c is 3. So this one, 3 times 3 is 9 plus 1. Okay, equals to 10. And this is the solution for this given linear equation. Okay, so let's try to solve a system of linear equations when we say solving, which means we are going to find the solution. Okay, so first by the method of substitution. So it is called substitution since we are going to equate one equation into a single variable, then substitute that variable into another equation. Okay, so we have here two equations. We're going to solve, or we're going to find the solution for this system of linear equations. Okay, first, let's work out this equation. The first equation, a minus 2b equals negative 10. So the way to solve this is we're going to equate this, let's say, in terms of a. So which means I'm going to transfer this negative 2b to the right side. So my new equation now in terms of a is a equals 2b positive minus 10, right? So I have now the value of a. I'm going to substitute that to the second equation. So 3a plus 5b. Okay, a is, okay, 2b minus negative 10. So this is what I'm going to substitute, okay, for that value of a. So the new equation now is 3 times 2b minus 10 plus 5b equals 14. Okay, next we can distribute this 3 times 2b, that is 6b, right? Then distribute this 3 to negative 10, that is of course negative 30. So what's next? I can transfer this negative 30 to the right side, that will make it positive. So we have now 6b plus 5b equals 14 plus 30. Okay, so 6b plus 5b, 6 plus 5, that is 11b. Of course, 14 plus 30 is 44. Okay, so let's simplify further this 11b equals 44. So we can divide it by 11, both sides. So this will cancel out this 11. And that will leave us b equals 4. So 44 divided by 11 is 4. I have now value of b equals 4. This is part of the solution of the system of linear equation, right? B equals 4. So since I have now the value of b, which is 4, I can substitute that to either this equation or this equation. Okay, I'm going to use this first equation. Again, you can also use the second. So it doesn't matter. It will have the same result. So I will use a minus 2b equals negative 10. So this is a minus, of course, b is positive 4. So negative 2 times 4 is negative 8 equals negative 10. Okay, transfer this to the right side. So it will become positive. So A is negative 10 plus 8. Of course, that will result to negative 2. And this is the value of A. So the solution for this given linear equation or system of linear equation is A equals negative 2 and B equals 4. And you can verify if this is correct. So this is some sort of checking if your solution is correct. We can substitute the values we obtain. So A is negative 2, right? And B is 4. So let's say to the first equation. So this is negative 2. So negative 2 minus 2 times 4, right? And this is negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. So negative 2 minus negative 8 is negative 10. So this is correct. So it satisfies the first equation. So let's check to the second equation. Okay, so let's substitute that value. So this is 3 times negative 2 plus 5 times 4, right? So 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. 5 times 4 is 20. Okay, so 20 minus 6, that is 14. So it satisfies both of the equation, which means these values, A equals negative 2 and B equals 4, is the solution for this given system of linear equations. Okay, so this is by substitution method. The another method is by elimination method. This is called elimination since the process is you are going to eliminate one of the variable. So let's say we are going to eliminate A. So how to eliminate A? The process is you have to multiply one of the equation by some value, some factor. Then the result is you are going to add to another equation. Okay? So let's say you are going to eliminate A. You have 3 here. The only way to eliminate this positive 3 is by adding negative 3, right? And that's what I'm going to do with the first equation. I will multiply my first equation with negative 3. So each of this term, I can distribute, okay, this negative 3. So that is negative 3 times A will result to negative 3A, right? Negative 3 times negative 2 is positive 6B. And negative 3 times negative 10 is positive 30. Okay? And of course, the second equation stays the same. And now, if I'm going to add, so again, the process is you multiply with some value, then add to another or to the other equation. So if I'm going to add now, so this negative 3 plus positive 3 will cancel it out. This will equate to 0, right? And this 6b plus 5b is 11b. Of course, 30 plus 14 is 44. So I think the format is quite familiar. Say 11b equals 44, right? And now I can divide both sides by 11. So this will cancel out this 11. This way it will equate to 1. Leaving b equals 4. 44 divided 11 or 44 divided by 11 is 4. And this is one of the solution, right? B equals 4. Okay, so you see now the process of elimination. Again, you multiply one equation with some value, then add to the other equation. Okay, so let's try again to eliminate, let's say, B this time. So how to eliminate B? So we have the coefficient of B from the first equation, negative 2. For the second, it's positive 5. The trick here is, if I have 5 here, I will multiply my first equation with that the same value. Then for the second equation, okay, I will multiply by positive 2. So that's the trick to eliminate this variable b. So my first equation now is, let's distribute, okay, that is 5a, right? So this one, 5 times negative 2 is negative 10. Then 5 times negative 10 is, of course, negative 50. So I will do the same with the second equation. I will multiply every term by 2. So this is 2 times 3. Okay, that is 6a. So this one, 2 times 5b, that is positive 10b. So 2 times 14 is positive 28. So as you can see now, we have here negative, we have positive. So this will cancel out that b. But if this, for example, this is not negative 2, this is positive 2, you can multiply it by negative to make it negative 10b. Okay, so you can also do that. Multiply by negative values. Okay, so anyway, let's add these new equations. So we have negative 10b plus positive 10b. This will cancel out this term. It will equate to 0. So we have now 5 plus 6, that is 11a. So of course, negative 50 plus 28 is negative 22. Okay, so we can divide both sides by 11. So this equates to 1. So a is negative 2. So we obtain the same value, yeah, using elimination and using substitution. Okay, so that is the two methods in solving system of linear equations. So like before, we can check, okay, by of course substituting these values to the original equations, it must satisfy that system of linear equations. Okay, so for the first equation, a is negative 2, b is 4, so this will equate to negative 10. So this is negative 8. Okay, negative 2 minus 8 is negative 10. So this one is negative 6 plus 20, so 20 minus 6 is 14. Okay, so that's how you check. Let's try another exercise. This time, we have three equations in this system of linear equations. And we are going to solve this first using substitution method. Okay, so we will pick one of these three equations. So it's up to you. But I think this second equation is easier to work with to start with. So we have negative a plus 2b minus c. I will equate this in terms of a. So I have negative here, which means I can transfer my a to the right side. That will make it positive. So what's left in the left side of the equation is 2b minus c. And I will rearrange a little bit of my equation. So this is the value of this equation in terms of a. So a is 2b minus c. Okay, so I have now the value of a. So this value I can substitute either of these two equations. So let's say I will select the first equation, the 2a minus 4b minus 2c equals 12. So I will substitute this value of a. Okay, so we have 2 times 2b minus c, right? Then I can distribute these two. So 2 times 2b is 4b. Of course, 2 times negative c is negative 2c. Then if you notice, I have here positive 4b and negative 4b. So I can cancel that out. 4b minus 4b is 0, right? Negative 2c minus 2c is negative 4c equals 12. Okay, so of course, I can divide both sides of the equation by negative 4. So this will equate to 1. So 12 divided by negative 4 is negative 3. And that is the value of c. So that is part of the solution of this linear equation. Now let's work out with the third equation. Okay, 5a minus 5b plus 3c equals 6. And take note, these are the values I have obtained. So I have the value of a and the value of c. So negative 3. And of course, I will substitute these values to my third equation. Okay, so let's work out first with the value of a. So this is 5 times 2b minus c, right? And I can distribute, okay, this 5. So that is what? 10b. And this one is, okay, negative 5c. Okay, next, I can work with this 10b. 10b minus 5. Of course, that is okay, positive 5b. And this one, negative 5c plus 3c, that is negative 2c. So equals 6. So next, I will use the value of c, which is negative 3. Okay, so we have now 5b minus 2 times negative 3. Of course, negative 2 times negative 3 is positive 6, right? So I can cancel both sides, right? So if I am transferring this positive 6 to the right side, yeah, that will make this negative. So 6 minus 6 is 0. So obviously, to make the right side of the equation 0, so the only way is I will set my b to 0. 5 times 0 is 0. And that is the value of b. Or you can divide by 5. Both sides. So divide by 5. Anyway, 0 divided by 5 is still 0. So that is my value of b. So equals 0. So what's left now is the value of a. Okay, so I will use this equation before, the first equation we derived. So a equals 2b minus c. Of course, b is 0, c is negative 3. So this will equate to 0. Okay, so negative, negative is positive. So the value of a is positive 3. And this is the solution for this given system of linear equation using substitution method. And we can check if our answer is correct by, of course, substituting these values to these three equations. So it must satisfy these three equations. Okay, so for the equation 1, so we have 2 times 3, that is 6. Of course, this is 0. Negative 2 times negative 3 is positive 6. Okay, 6 plus 6 is 12. Okay, that is correct. So this one, this is 0. Negative 3. So plus 3, negative, times negative, right, positive 3. So negative 3 plus 3 is 0. Okay, that is correct. So this one is 15, of course, 0. This one is negative 9. So 15 minus 9. Okay, that is 6. Okay, so it satisfies all these three equations in the system of linear equations. And of course, our answer is correct. Okay? Okay, next is by elimination method. So we have three equations, but the process stays the same. So it doesn't matter if you have five equations in a system of linear equations. The process is you have to work two equations at a time. Okay, so for example, we have to work with the first and second equation. So we will eliminate one of the variables, okay, for these two equations. So let's say we're going to eliminate A. So how to eliminate A? Okay, I have 2 here, I have negative here. So which means I will multiply the second equation by 2, right? So let's distribute. First, that is, or that is the first equation. So the second equation, we have negative 2a. Okay, so we have positive 4b. Okay, negative 2c. So equals 0. Now we can add these two equations. So this positive 2a and negative 2a, when we add, that will equate to 0. So this term will cancel out. And luckily, we can also eliminate the b. So our goal is to eliminate A, but okay, we can also eliminate B. So that will equate to 0. So what's left is negative 2C plus negative 2C, which is negative 4C. Of course, 12 plus 0 is 12. Then we can divide by negative 4, both sides of the equation. So this one equates to 1. Negative 4 divided by negative 4 is 1. So C is negative 3. Okay, 12 divided by negative 4 is negative 3. And we obtain our first part of the solution, which is C equals negative 3. Okay, so let's work out another two equations. Let's say first equation and the last equation, the third equation. So again, you can select any two of this equation with the aim to eliminate one of the variables. So let's say I will also eliminate A in these two equations. But before eliminating A, I think we can substitute the value of C to simplify our equation. We know C is negative 3, right? So let's substitute that first. So we have now negative 2 times negative 3 for the first equation. Second is 3 times negative 3. So this will equate negative 2 times negative 3 is positive 6. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. Then we will transfer to the right side of the equation. Positive 6. Okay, will become negative 6. Negative 9 is, of course, positive 9. So 12 minus 6, of course, that is 6. And 6 plus 9 is 15. Okay, so this is now our reduced equation. Now we can eliminate A. So if you remember the trick, I have here 5, I have here 2. So we kind of switching that coefficient. But in order to eliminate that, one of them must be negative, right? Since we are going to add. Or if you are going to subtract, then there's no need that one of the A will be negative. Since I'm choose to the process of addition, so I will make the first equation negative. So not just 5, but negative 5. So I will multiply this equation by negative 5. And the second equation, I will multiply by positive 2. Okay, now we can distribute this negative 5. So that is negative 10A, right? Negative 5 times negative 4 is positive 20, 20B. Negative 5 times 6 is negative 30. Okay, next, this one. 2 times 5 is, of course, positive 10A. So as you can see, we have negative here, we have positive here. So we can eliminate that later. So 2 times negative 5 is, of course, negative 10B. And 2 times 15 is 30. Okay, so let's add. Of course, this one will equate to 0. We have 20B minus 10B. Of course, that is positive 10B. And negative 30 plus 30 is 0. Okay, so again, how to make this right side of the equation 0? So the only way is to multiply your 10 by 0. So that is the value of B equals 0. Or you can just divide both sides of the equation by 10. So anyway, 0 divided by 10 is still 0. So this is one of the solution, B equals 0. Okay, next, let's find the value of A. So we'll be using the same equation, but this time, we'll eliminate B. Okay, so to eliminate B, again, the trick is we have negative 5 here, negative 4 here. So we'll swap that coefficient, but one of them must be negative. So for example, this one, I can make it 5. I will multiply the first equation by 5. This one is negative 4. So that if I'm going to multiply negative and negative, so that will result to positive. Or you can either make it negative 5, this one is positive 4. So either way. Okay, so again, it will result in the same answer. Okay, so let's distribute this first. 5 times 2a, that is 10a. 5 times negative 4, of course, negative 20. 5 times 6 is positive 30. For the second part of the equation, negative 4 times 5, so negative 20a. Negative 4 times negative 5 is positive 20. Okay, so that's why I multiply this equation by negative. So that we have here positive 20, and the first part of the equation is negative 20. So that I can cancel out that b. Okay, so negative 4 times positive 15 is negative 60. So let's add these two equations. Obviously, this one equates to 0. So 10a plus negative 20a is negative 10a. Of course, 30 plus negative 60 is negative 30. Then we can divide both sides by negative 10. So this one will equate to 1. That will give us negative 30 divided by negative 10 is positive 3. So the value of A is 3. So we have now our solution. So these are the values of A, B, and C using the elimination method. And of course, we can check this one, and we have done it already in the substitution method. And it must satisfy these three equations. Okay, so this will equate to 12. This one equates to 0. And this one equates to positive 6. Okay? And this is the end for this lecture in solving system of linear equation using two methods, substitution and elimination. So in the next lecture, we'll be solving system of linear equation but in the form of matrix. So see you there.